Smoke. Welcome back to the Double MB Mop channel, man. Today, we are back with Johnny Cash. This is Cocaine Blues. Now, after, you know, doing my research and after hearing the song Hurt, I do know that Johnny Cash was addicted to drugs. Now, most of y'all said heroin. Cocaine and heroin are two completely different drugs. From what I know, y'all know I'm stupid, so... But I believe it's safe to say, like, I think heroin is more of like a downer. Like, you kind of like just get away from life. And cocaine is a little bit more like sociable and like you party. So the fact that it's cocaine blues, like you associate cocaine with a good time. So the fact that you put blues behind it. I really want to know the approach that Johnny Cash take with this. And just for the record, because I know some people going to ask me to do it, I reacted to A Boy Named Sue. It got blocked. So it's up on the Patreon. Again, Patreon, only a dollar. Once we get to 100 patrons, I'm doing a $100 giveaway. So just wanted to throw that out there. I did A Boy Named Sue. It got blocked. I'm in the process of trying to get it on YouTube, but... I'm sure a lot of y'all know how that go. So, just want to throw that out there. But, Johnny Cash, Cocaine Blues. I've only heard, what, 2-3 songs by Johnny Cash. I think I love all 3 or 4 of them. All 2 or 3 of them. Like, it's, and I found out it's called Talking Blues. Talking Blues. So, it's off the arm of folk music. So, a folk music, if I'm saying it wrong. I love that description of it, because that's exactly what it is. Like, every story he tells is very, very depressing, but he's talking. I love that genre. And I want to hear some more. Like, I would love to hear some other talking blues artists, like, people who have this style of just talking, but it being in a musical way. I would love to dive into that deeper. So, but Johnny Cash, Cocaine Blues, let's go.
Early one morning while making the rounds, I took a shot of cocaine and I shot my woman down. I went right home.
Okay. For one, he said, let me go back. I took a shot of cocaine. Now, of course, it's music. I'm not trying to be like a dick here when I like look up everything, but I this is genuinely how I learn, because y'all know I'm stupid, so I gotta, this is how I learn. I didn't know you could shoot cocaine. That sounds so lethal that I'm like, I couldn't even believe that was like the first line of the song. Can you shoot cocaine? Cocaine is a drug. It can be injected. I did not know that. I thought cocaine, you snort it or you could smoke it. I thought cocaine through injection was like so like lethal, like it wasn't even a thing. That is okay. All right. And then I went home, shot my woman down. I stuck that loving 44 beneath my head. Like, if it wasn't for the beat, like, it has a very uplifting, tempo beat. This is one of the eeriest, depressing songs I think I've ever heard in, like, 15 seconds. Like, this is nuts.
I stuck that loving 44 beneath my head. Got up next morning. Grab that gun, took a shot of cocaine and away Mexico. And the hot joints taking the pill. And walked the sheriff from Jericho Hill. He said, "Well, Ely, your name is not Jack Brown. You're the dirty hack that shot your woman down." Yes, oh yes, my name is Willie Lee. If you've got a warrant, just to read it to me. Shot her down because she made me slow. I thought I was her daddy, but she had five more. When I was arrested, I was dressed in black. They put me on a train and they took me back. Had no friend for to go my bail. They slapped a dead carcass in the county jail. Early next morning, about a half past nine, I spied a sheriff coming down the line. A steady cough as he cleared his throat. He said, "Let alone you dirty hack into that district court."
Yo, again, everything that I hear from Johnny Cash is a conversational story. It's like somebody asked him a question and he's answering the question. And in this like story, like somebody, I don't even know what I'm trying to say, but it's like everything I hear from Johnny Cash, it's like a story. It's crazy.
Into the courtroom my trial began, where I was held by 12 honest men. Just before the jury started out, I saw that little judge come as to look about. In about 5 minutes in walked a man, holding the verdict in his right hand. The verdict read in the first degree. I hollered, "Lordy, Lordy, have mercy on me." The judge, he smiled as he picked up his pen. 99 years in the Folsom pen. 99 years underneath that ground. I can't forget the day I shut that bad bitch down. Come on, you gotta listen unto me. Lay off that whiskey and let that cocaine be.
Okay. Alright, I don't know if that was supposed to be funny, but that was actually pretty funny. Actually, A Boy Named Sue, like, that was kinda not funny, but funny. Like, again, the beat, a lot of country music that I hear that sounds like this, it almost has like a circus comedy like type of feel. Like I don't know why, but like it almost gives off the impression that it's supposed to be funny or something lighthearted, you know, which is good, because given the stories, if these songs were given like a different beat, again, these are some of the most depressing and like brutal songs ever. The first line of the song is, "I shot cocaine, I shot my girl, I put the 44 beneath the bed, I put it underneath my head." Like, these songs are crazy. But again, it's in such a lighthearted, up-tempo style, like, it's almost comedic. I love it. I love it. It almost reminds me of one of them songs where you like, y'all know what I'm trying to say, where it's like you grab somebody's arm and you keep swinging around the room to another person. Like, hold on, let me move the chair. It's like you, I don't know what it, y'all, I'm gonna put it on the screen, but y'all know what I'm talking about. It's the dance where you just like grab somebody's arm and you swing around to the next person. Like, I don't know, it just has such a fun feel to it. But again, the story itself, like, if you remove the beat and just heard these lyrics, it's the most depressing shit I think I've ever heard. But I like it. I really, really do. You know something? I wish more artists took that approach. Like, had a more, like, and I guess it's just the times we're in, everybody's so sensitive. Like, do y'all think Johnny Cash could have, like, existed in this era where, like, you openly talk about taking drugs, shooting your wife, like the last artist that I know of that, like, did that and, like, really got away with it was, like, Eminem. I mean, of course, you got rappers today that talk about the crimes they commit. And I'm not talking about Johnny Cash right now. Because I would hope, outside of him doing drugs, because, again, y'all let me know that he really did do that. I don't suspect Johnny Cash shot his wife. I don't suspect Johnny did anything in this song. But, you know, I just wish artists had a more, I don't know. I just like this approach. I like this style. I love that style of storytelling in an uplifting way, even if it's something like crazy. And again, they do it in rap, but like in rap, they literally talk about the crimes that they have committed, like they're under investigation for. And then they go to jail for it. So it's like, I don't mean that way. I just wish more artists had more fun in writing in this way. I'll say that. But yeah, Johnny Cash did it again, man. I hope this don't get blocked because I really, really liked it. And again, if you, of course, you didn't see A Boy Named Sue. So if you want to see that, that's on Patreon, only for $1. But I think I might like this one better than A Boy Named Sue. I do. I don't know why. I'm going to have to go back and listen to A Boy Named Sue again. But I think I like this one better. I think I like this one better. But I'm going to go back and listen to it. But as always, like, comment, subscribe. Let me know how y'all feel. Let me know which song you think is better. And let me know if y'all think Johnny Cash could have existed in today's era with the sensitivity and how people are nowadays. Like, I really don't hear a song like this surviving in today. Like, I don't know if it was this a big hit? Because if this was a big hit, like, oh boy, how times have changed. Cocaine Blues, Johnny Cash. Good old Johnny Cash. Let's see what we got. A Western swing song. Is that what it's called? Swing music? That's exactly what it sounded like. Oh no. Hold on. The song was written by Troy Arnold, a reworking of the traditional song Little Sadie. Roy Hawkshead recorded as well a known version of the song in 1944. Gotcha. But Johnny Cash's version came out in 68. He famously performed the song at his 1968 Folsom Prison concert. Wow. So did he make this whole, like, did he make his rendition of the song, like, for his... Oh, that's... Oh, man. So Johnny can freestyle. Like, Johnny off the dome with it. Because he said Folsom... Oh, okay, that's dope. That's dope. Gotcha. Oh, he replaced the lyric San Quentin with Folsom. And change "Come On You Hypes" to "Come On You Gotta Unto Me, You Gotta Listen Unto Me." Gotcha. Wait, Johnny Cash performed at Madison Square Garden? In 2002, Johnny Cash performed in Madison Square Garden. Oh no, the concert was in 1969. Oh wow, that's amazing. Oh man, okay. Apparently I got a lot more to learn about Johnny Cash. But as always, like, comment, subscribe. I appreciate y'all for watching. Until next time.